finally tonight, another way of looking at the ongoing economic crisis in Greece. Jeffrey Brown was in Athens recently and talked to two poets about hard times now and in the nation's past.
All right, so sometimes you're out with the kids and the demonstration starts?
Well, we've got a friend who lives in the center, and we've had play dates where we've had to sort of figure out when we think the riot's going to start.
An American poet in Athens, Alicia Stallings, moved here 13 years ago with her Greek husband.
I think you have your sock inside Athens.
They now have two young children and have watched the nation go from the euphoria of the entry into the euro and the hosting of the Olympic Games to the despair of an ongoing financial crisis that's having severe economic and social consequences.
You see, every time you walk down the street, there'll be shops newly closed or having a sellout sale, or you see more homeless people on the streets, you see more people begging, and different class of people begging, not professional beggars, people who had recently been, you know, sort of somewhere at the bottom of the middle class.
Stallings is trained as a classicist, reading ancient Greek and Latin. She did an acclaimed translation of the Roman philosopher Lucretius's The Nature of Things, and her own poetry has garnered several prizes. In 2011, she was the recipient of a MacArthur Fellowship, the so-called Genius Award. Her latest collection, titled Olives, explores, among other things, ancient and modern lives in her adopted home.
There's weirdly a lot of energy in Athens, and whether that's good or bad, there's a feeling.
What kind of energy?
Maybe there's a, that there's nothing left to lose is a kind of freedom as well. People are going out to plays. They are still going out and doing things, but, you know, with less money. And but there's an urgency. Poetry readings are very well attended. Literary events are packed.
Why do you think that is?
I think it's inexpensive entertainment. But B, I think people want to be together. They want to be talking to people.
The crisis around her, she says, rarely makes it into her poetry in an explicit way. But she did have one direct hit for us, a playful work in progress called Austerity Measures.
I love the term austerity measures. It sounds so poetic.
Even though it's so real and nitty-gritty and what's happening
here.
Yes,
but I love, you know, the idea of measures as, you know, as verse. It was prompted by a headline that I read somewhere, which was Greece downgraded deeper into junk, the Greek bonds. And it scanned nicely, and I was just, I just wanted to play with it. So this is, I'm just playing with it. Austerity measures. If you believe the headlines, then we're sunk. The dateline oracle, giddy with dread, Greece downgraded deeper into junk. Stash cash beneath the mattress, pack the trunk. Will drachmas creep where euros fear to dread? If you believe the headlines, then we're sunk. A crisis that lasts for years, call it a funk. Austerity starves the more its maw is fed and downgrades all our deepest bonds to junk. Every politician is a punk. The right, the left, the blue, the green, the red, ministers in cahoots with the odd monk. We've lost our marbles. Elgin took a chunk. Caryatids gone on strike, sit down instead. Tear gas lingers like a whiff of skunk. Weep, Pericles, or maybe just get drunk. We'll hawk the Parthenon to buy our bread. If you believe the headlines, then we're sunk. Greece downgraded deeper into junk.
If these are interesting times in Greece, where you can see a man crawling into a recycling bin to cart away newspapers he'll sell for a pittance, and of course the weekly, sometimes daily, protest by various government workers, well, Titos Patrikios is a man who knows interesting times.
Interesting and difficult, but perhaps every interesting time is also a very difficult time. Easy times are not interesting, perhaps.
Easy times are not interesting.
A poet and elder statesman of Greek letters, he's seen many of the hardships and horrors of Greek history in the 20th century, including the German occupation in World War II.
Here is Athens during the occupation, a street in the central quarter of Athens. against the occupation.
So this was part of your life at that time?
Yes, somewhere I was there.
Somewhere you're back in the crowd?
Yes.
Even more devastating, he says, was the Greek Civil War that followed, one that led to his own captivity and torture on an island prison.
So you've seen much worse.
For I give always this example that during the winter of 1940-41, every day I was going to my high school. In order to get in the courtyard, I had to go over one, two, sometimes three dead people died during the night there.
And this is Hymettus.
Today, he sees his country in a different kind of crisis, one especially difficult for the young, that goes beyond just the economic.
An economic crisis always creates also other crises.
What kind of crisis?
Social crisis, personal crisis, psychological crisis, existential crisis. Every latent crisis finds the possibility to come out.
You see that happening now?
Yes, yes.
A selection from 7 decades of Patrikios' poetry has been translated into English in a volume titled The Lion's Gate. The title poem ends like this.
Our past is forever full, terrible, just as the story of what happened is terrible, curved as it is now, written on the lintel of the gate we pass through every day.
Have you decided what the role of a poet is then?
The role of the poet is to observe, not only to feel, to discover through his observations a small aspect that was not seen up to the moment that he writes down.
Titos Patrikios still writes every day. A new volume in Greek came out just this year. And above all, it seems, he maintains his sense of humor, as when I asked his age.
84. 84, yes. Yeah. Sometimes I read, I laugh with that.
Why?
I laugh because I say it's incredible. How did I manage to arrive to that age?
These days, Greece can use some of that laughter. And with its own rich and often troubled history, from ancient times to today, the poet's sense of purpose and survival.
We have more poems from Stallings and Patrikios on our poetry page, as well as a conversation with Greek novelist Ersi Soteropoulos. Find that on Artbeat.